So, remember Philip Mewson, the former IGN editor who was fired from the major news outlet after he was caught plagiarizing his review for Dead Cells? This wasn't a one-time thing either. Soon after allegations of plagiarism began to spread, you may recall that people on the internet went through his content from the YouTube channel he ran before he was employed by IGN, and numerous other examples were discovered as well. Philip then further accelerated his downfall by publishing one of the most disingenuous apology videos to have ever been uploaded on YouTube, in which he not only failed to acknowledge the exact nature of his mistakes and to properly apologize to afflicted parties, but also attacked Kotaku's Jason Schreier for unearthing other content Philip clearly plagiarized by claiming that Jason's making false accusations for clicks while challenging him to find other content on Philip's channel that wasn't original, refuting claims of plagiarism. Jason and the rest of the internet took the challenge head on, and well, even more examples of plagiarized content was unearthed. Philip had the opportunity to come clean then and move forward, but instead, he played the victim card, and that was when he sealed his fate. After that, Philip pretty much lost whatever ounce of credibility and chance at swift redemption he had left. It's been a little over 2 months since, and the general hope was that Philip would learn from his mistakes and find a way to move forward in a path outside of games journalism, a ship that Philip sank with his own hands. But just yesterday, on October 18th, 2018, Philip Mewson decided to return to YouTube by uploading his very first video since the whole debacle. Now, whether you think Philip has a chance at redemption in the field of games journalism after what he did and everything that's happened will vary from person to person, I for one think that his blunders are far too severe for him to ever be able to have any semblance of credibility as a games journalist or critic, whether it be as an individual content creator or as a journalist for a media outlet. It would have been one thing if it was a one-time case of plagiarism that he properly owned up to and took responsibility for, but it's a whole other thing for him to have been doing this for years and not admit to it to this very day. I'm all for Philip finding some form of personal redemption, but I think he should find it elsewhere, as in the field of content creation and games journalism and critique, his work will always be doubted and scrutinized. Now, there may be those out there who think Philip deserves a second chance as a games journalist or critic, and that's fine, but at the very least, I think we can all agree that in order for him to even begin to walk a path of regaining the trust he shattered, he needs to come out clean and issue a proper apology, one where he acknowledges exactly where he went wrong and how he'll work towards rectifying those mistakes moving forward. It's really not a lot to ask for given his circumstances, and yet, even after all this time, after all that's happened, Philip refuses to issue a proper apology. In the opening seconds of his latest video, he briefly referenced having reflected on the ordeal he's faced over the past 2 months, but makes no real direct reference to his transgressions.
I know, it's been a really long time since I uploaded. But while I've been gone, I've had time to reflect on things. You see, the ups and downs of this past year have made me realize just how much I love doing this. Making videos for you, right here on YouTube. It's exactly where I want to be, and I hope that you stay along for the ride, because I'm going to be working hard to make this channel better than it ever was before. So with that being said, let's take a look at the best Bluetooth audio transmitter for Nintendo Switch.
Philip, dude, this isn't the kind of scenario where you can just say, I've had time to reflect, I'll make the channel better. With that said, let's move on to my content, and expect people to forget what happened. Your missteps aren't something that you can just gloss over and brush aside, like some passing thought or topic of discussion. It is something that you need to take time to directly address. Now, Philip did issue a more formal statement in the comments section of this particular video, but if this is his idea of a proper apology, boy is he in for a rough ride moving forward. The fact that his attempt at a proper apology is in the comments is bad enough as it is, but then you actually read it and realize the contents are far worse. The statement reads, quote, "Hey everyone, in the past several weeks, I have learned a multitude of hard lessons that continue to remind me of my missteps and the steps that I need to take to make things right. I would like you to know how truly sorry I am. I apologize to everyone personally affected, as well as the entire gaming community. From here on out, I will do everything in my power to make things right. I will continue to work on being a better person every day and hope that it will be reflected in my actions to come. Thank you, Philip." As you can see for yourself, not once does he ever use the word plagiarism to address his missteps, and not once does he directly reference the folks at IGN who placed their trust in him, all the numerous content creators and news outlets he directly ripped content from, or folks like Jason Schreier who Philip verbally attacked and challenged. This right here is just about the most boilerplate, non-apology Philip could have issued, about as empty as the typical "we're listening to feedback" statements that game companies are prone to issue to address any kind of backlash. Philip's so-called apology reads like a template for a typical PR apology rather than something that took genuine thought to write and extrapolate. His statement doesn't at all give off the sense that he's sincerely sorry for what he did. What exactly are the hard lessons you learned? What exactly are the missteps that you're reminded of? And what exactly are the steps that you need to take to make things right? It isn't just a matter of saying, "I am sorry," it's a matter of saying, "I am sorry for." To make matters worse, Philip is going around handing out hearts only to comments that welcome his return or that outright forgive him, which are more prominently displayed than the comments that are being reasonably critical about the way he's handled the situation and continues to handle the situation. Even with a proper apology, it's still a tall order to ask the general public to trust you again, given the gravity of your transgressions, given how it wasn't just the one skeleton they found in your closet. But that order becomes an impossibility if you don't take the time to directly talk to your audience, to those being reasonably critical, to the people you attacked and to the people you affected. If you continue with your non-apologies and your impersonal statements, if you continue to pretend that this is all something we'll just forget about, I guarantee that there isn't a chance in hell at making a comeback and getting out of this rut so long as you continue to treat people like they're dumb and have short memories, as long as you continue to pretend that you can just wait out the storm before things just go back to normal. That's not gonna happen. If you're not going to issue a genuine confession and apology, Philip, for your sake and for the sake of the gaming community, just please go away. Maybe that's harsh to say, but honestly, I have no sympathy for the shameless and for those too thick-headed to do the right thing. And again, even if he were to properly apologize, given the gravity and extent of what he did, there is still no guarantee that he'll ever be taken seriously again. I hope that Philip's life won't be defined by the stupid and scummy decisions he's made during his tenure as a journalist or critic, and that he'll find a way to move forward. But I also hope that he'll either quit while he's ahead, or that he'll grow some balls and make amends in a genuine way before he digs himself into a deeper hole than the one he's already in. These are one man's thoughts and opinions anyway. I'd love to hear what your take is on Philip Mewson's return and his latest statements in the comments below. With that, I would like to end this news update. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy my content and would like to support this channel directly, consider donating on Patreon. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.